We're beginning to get ready for the ceiling now. And had to make everything level. Had to sand with the belt sander all along the edges here. This is that channel, or that rabbeted edge that you heard so much about in the last videos when I was helping Christina. She had to create that edge. There's a little bit of couple of places where it's not in real good shape, but that's okay, won't matter. And so I belt sanded everything down so that the paneling was level with the top in preparation for the gip all the way around. This area does not get any paneling because it's all covered with diamond, quilted aluminum. So, and there's a cabinet up here. I'm gonna paint this white before it gets covered up. And basically we're just getting ready for the first 2 4-foot wide ceiling panels, which will come right up to about here somewhere. And then I want to button up the back, get it all square and solid again, and then we'll move on to the front. So today is gimp day because tomorrow is ceiling day. And the gimp that I'm using is like this. It's hollow welt, rubber welt, and it's sand colored. And of course that'll go along the whole top like that, stapled in. I use an aero stapler that uses T50 staples, and I use 3/8 inch staples. I gotta use up the bits and pieces from this box and then I can open up a new box. So that's the way I install it. I've tried other ways. Nothing else works better than this from what I can see. Now, I've shown you how to do gimp, or welting if you will, in other videos, but I just thought I'd go over this quickly. I don't have time to do a full video on gimp. I gotta get this done, but I put the staples every 2 to 3 inches, as you can see, 3 fingers between, maybe 4, but no more than that, all along. Have to make sure that the gimp is tied up that way, push it up against the wall and stretch it as you staple it. You have to get used to using both hands on the stapler to do this. So hopefully you're ambidextrous. On an inside corner, I just cut it and start again. But on an outside corner, I actually wrap it. And you see I cut out inside here at a 45 degree angle in both directions to get around this corner. I just use a razor knife for that, and then we continue on down. Before I leave the area and move on down, I always come along and knock these down, flatten them out with a little baby hammer. And continue on down the line. As you can see, it's looking pretty good, and when the ceiling goes on, it'll flatten it out even more and look even better. Now, before you start commenting saying, hey, wouldn't an air stapler be better? So you wouldn't have to go back there and hammer it down? No. You need to use these kind of staples, and an air stapler doesn't work as well. It's harder to get in, you got that hose to move around, and I've already tried that. So if you want to go ahead and use an air stapler, you go ahead, you'll see what I'm talking about. Okay, I am installing these cross pieces. These are the exact ones that came off the trailer. No reason to make new ones. These are in great shape. They're not rotted or anything. They're lightweight. Here's the old piece of paneling that I'm matching up. And I just took the piece off here and I'm installing it over there. And it's a good thing to take photographs of the trailer while you're taking it apart so you can use them for reference later. I know where these go and how they go, what side of the framing they go on, because I looked at the photographs that I took. And they go, you can see there that I marked where the rear of the trailer is when I built this panel. So I know that's the rear of the trailer. So I know these go on the front. And I know, you know, I take them off one piece at a time and install it over there. So that's what I'm doing right now. We're gonna have these, have two ceiling panels up today, hopefully. All I did was just beat the nails back and using the same nails and everything. It's nice to have a small hammer for small jobs like this. You don't want to hurt this thing. So I'm beating right where the nail is, just a little bit, loosen them all up. Then we use the flat bar. You gotta go a little bit at a time so you don't break this thing. And there we are. Now we gotta beat the nails back. A little bit. I hope I don't bend it too much. There we go. We just lay it on here again towards this way. Get it lined up on both ends. Grab our tiny hammer. So there they are, just like the old ceiling panels. This one is ready to go on. And if you remember in a previous video, Danielle was here with me and we made these ceiling panels to match the old ceiling panels which had vinyl on them with speckles. And we couldn't find that stuff anywhere, so we spray painted these white sprinkled vinyl, speckles on them, gold and silver, just to match what was there before, and went three coats of urethane, clear urethane over that. So in a little bit we're going to be installing this first panel. It's going to be great. I can't wait. Bill's in here doing a little bit of prep work. I didn't want to leave the inside of this cabinet unpainted and unsealed. And the most important thing right now, so we don't, you're not supposed to do that, Bill. Remember? Because they all got mad at me.
The fumes.
I can't say stand there and look stupid anymore because there you are standing there looking stupid. See, folks, it was just a joke between, we banter. Men banter.
There's bantering going on here.
Yeah. And nothing, I've known Bill, how long have we known each other?
30 years.
Over 30 years.
At least.
We've been hang gliding and camping and fishing and everything, skydiving and everything together for over 30 years. We've been through thick and thin. We've gotten mad enough at each other. I don't know if we've ever actually taken a swing at each other.
Oh, not really.
Yeah, no. but we're both trained in martial arts. If we did, we'd kill each other.
Yeah, we'd both have to die.
Yeah, we'd have to both die. So when I say stand there and look stupid, it's just because he has nothing to do. So what are you going to do? You just stand there and look stupid for a while. I didn't mean anything by it. But anyway, I digress.
I've been practicing.
I want to put GIMP around the top here, so I wanted to make sure and get a little bit of paint on there. Same over here, and then we'll paint the rest later, but I want to get these two ceiling panels in today. So still need to add a little GIMP in there. In here, the refrigerator's going in here, so we don't need to worry about it. So anytime now, won't be long now, we'll be getting the two ceiling panels. This one and the one next to it. And I can't wait. I just can't wait.
Yeah.
Oh man, it's gonna be great.
Okay, here we go. The moment of truth that we've been waiting for. Okay, you need to lift it up. Now wait a minute. And you're gonna be holding on to that wood stuff and everything.
Yeah.
And then get it by the bottom. So get it up as high as you can now. Do you need help?
No, hang on. Just putting it on my shoes.
No. You need help?
No, hang on. Just putting it on my shoes.
Let me know if you need help. Okay, hold it a minute. Okay, now you have to tilt it out.
Right. Hold on. Okay. Hold on. Okay,
great. Hold on.
I got it.
All right, now pick it up. Don't drag it.
Okay.
Follow me.
Hold on.
I'm holding.
Okay. I'm not holding much.
I know. Hang on to it.
I got it.
Now the whole thing has to go towards the rear a bit. A little more. Right there. All right, now the whole thing, your end has to go to the right just a bit. To the right a bit. I got to square it off. Right there. You hold that puppy right there.
Got it. I got about an inch sticking out over the wall, so.
Great. I have to get up on the other side now because I didn't think far enough in advance. Darn it.
You got to push the wall in.
Well.
Can you like spin?
Yeah, I have to push the wall. I have to get out there to nail it. I can't nail it from in here. That's the problem.
Okay, well, if you stay right here.
So wait a minute. Just hold on to it right there. Don't move anything. I'm going outside.
Okay.
I'm going to hang the nailer out there. And I'm going to put up a ladder. Hang on to it now, okay?
I got it.
This is for all the money. For all the marbles. Okay, the whole thing has to go to your right just a hair. Okay, that's enough. Okay, hang on. Right. Okay, the whole thing has to pivot a little bit.
To my left.
To your right.
To my right?
To your right.
How's that?
That's good.
Okay, now.
Hold on.
Okay.
Because there's some other shit we gotta do, but I gotta get your side nailed first.
Yeah.
So.
And that, this, my left side wall needs to kind of come out because
I know.
Yeah.
Okay, that's enough. Okay, hang on.
Got it.
Now I gotta move this gun because I'm having a hard time going through this window.
Go ahead.
Okay, the whole thing has to pivot a little bit.
To your right. To my right?
To your right.
How's that?
That's good.
Okay, now.
Okay, hold on.
Okay.
There's some other shit we gotta do, but I gotta get your side nailed first.
Yeah.
So.
And that, this, my left side wall needs to kind of come out because I know. Yeah.
Just let me get this first.
Yeah. Okay. That's as high as I can.
Okay. I'll hold it. You get the.
You got it?
Yeah.
The ceiling. Is the gimp staying on?
Yeah, careful. No, you're pulling the gimp. Here, I'll lift it.
Oh!
You're not supposed to do that.
Hang on. Okay.
We got a lot wrong here already. But,
Ooh.
This whole thing needs to go that way.
Right? Yeah, perfect. Now it looks even.
Yeah.
Okay, you're moving it.
I know. Just hang on.
Okay.
Get it in there.
There you go.
Now
I'm holding it.
I still have to move the whole thing that way.
There. Perfect.
There, got it. All right, we're in there. It really bounce that camera around.
Yeah, that's
nice. Alright. I got the ceiling material tacked in, but now I want to nail in the framing, so I have to remember that this isn't very thick, this wall, so you don't want to drill down through anything, so you got to go at a little bit of an angle. You don't want to split the wood, and that's why we're drilling pilot holes. Bill's over there making faces at me. And you people get bummed out because they go, "Hey, Bill, don't just stand there and look stupid, will you?"
Okay.
Y'all, when I get done with one of my videos, do you have to go to the recovery room? And
yeah.
Because you're offended.
I am.
Oh, I hit a nail dead on. Can you believe that?
Yeah.
I did that yesterday. It really made me mad. Here we go. The first panel is in. Well, I gotta do the same thing to the other side now. Same thing here.
this panel is basically in. Now what we have to do, we have to get the splice piece that goes along this edge, splices two panels together. We'll put that in, and then we can place our next panel. So let's get that going. So there's the ceiling. We have one more panel to go here, a big one, and then this small one here. We'll get to that as I tear the front apart. But the next thing we're going to do is button up the back end right here. I'm going to button that up. It'll be paneled just like this. Looks great. Sorry I didn't show it, but we put this splicer here. This is the one that splices the back panels to the ceiling panels. And it just slid right on there, and we angled it down at the right angle so it can meet up with the back panels. And you'll see how that works when I put the back panels in. The front one is still in there, as you can see. Let's see, yeah. That white thing right there. Anyway. Yeah, we'll, when I slip the back panels in there, I'll make sure and video that. Of course, I had to put the bathroom back in, the shower tub, and the aluminum wall. We had this all powder coated, if you remember.
People are making fun of the back of my head, so stop it.
Alright, that's it for today's vlog number 5, an update on the 66 Super Shasta.